Hey, Upendra, stop, that's him. he's getting ready to take on one of mine's. Upendra Chivukula he has done an amazing job for Somerset County in the state legislature. Even though he only represents one of our towns, we have claimed ownership of him because we have very few other people who represent this county in Trenton. So thank you, Upendra, for all your efforts. He's a really smart guy. I've said to him, if we succeed, or when we succeed in sending him to Washington, he's going to be the second smartest guy in Congress because Rush Holt is number one. He's an engineer by trade, which makes him a problem solver. Guys, we sure need some problem solvers in Washington. But I'm personally thrilled and gratified that Upendra was willing to step up and take on this very difficult battle. He agreed to do it in my office. I think it was a weak moment. I don't know, maybe Daisy had him in the doghouse or something. I said, so what do you think? What's your next step? I want to go to Congress. Well, then maybe you should move. I probably don't have to move. The rules don't require me to live in the district, and I can promise to move sometime in the future. I said, great. We're looking for somebody in CD7. And then he said, no, you have a lot of other people that are possibilities. You got this guy said, I got a farmer, I got this. I said, no. You're the only possible real candidate and somebody who we are underrepresented, severely underrepresented in Washington by Leonard Lance. Leonard Lance might have been a nice guy in but he is a terrible Tea Party guy. He doesn't care about Mandeville, he doesn't care about Greenbrook, he doesn't even care about anything going on in this county because he's caring more about getting reelected. So, even though he knew and I knew that this was a major uphill battle, this guy's actually running like he means it. And he's making believers out of a lot of us. He's making believers out of the DCCC. The DCCC says, wait, an emerging race, sir. So when he wins, it was all my idea and I take all the credit, and when he loses, you know, Upendra screwed up.
Somerset County gave me that opportunity to become a good Democrat. I got the opportunity to be successful. It's time for us to stand up and talk about what is good for middle-class America. But no matter what you do, you have to be the best you can be, so that way you succeed. And I am confident that we are going to beat Leonard Lance, and with your help, thank you very much.
Who's to say what's impossible? Will they forget? This world keeps spinning, and with each new day I can feel a change in everything. And as the surface breaks, reflections fade, but in some ways they remain the same. And as my mind begins to spread its wings, there's no stopping curiosity. I wanna turn the whole thing upside down. I'll find the things they say just can't be found. I'll share this love I find with everyone. We'll sing and dance to Mother Nature's songs. I don't want this feeling to go away. I can't do everything, but I can try.
All right, thank you very much for that introduction. Are you ready? Greg Schaefer told me that I need a candidate, I want you to run for office. Initially I didn't know, but I talked to Zena, I talked to my wife, and I talked to many friends. They said, you got a chance, do it. And with that I started. I can go over some of the details. It was March 25th when I finally decided to run. April 2nd was the filing deadline, and we have this district, which is 565 square miles, 75 towns, parts of 6 counties. We have to get signatures so that way we can get on the ballot. On April 2nd, when I wanted to go and submit petitions, I didn't have any staff. I couldn't use my district staff because it's people are watching. And I went there, I stood in the line for 3 hours. They kept calling me. I haven't done it yet. She was worried that maybe I don't file my paperwork. But I did it, and I called her, I said, I got my paper sent. Then I'm looking for staff. I can't find anybody because all the people were taken by President Obama for his $1 billion fundraising. Then you have, we have 2 primaries going on, one in District 10, Donald Payne, opposed by another 5 candidates. Then you have District 9, you have Congressman Rockman challenging, or the other way around, Congressman Bill Pascrell, was going on, a lot of staff were taken. I didn't have any staff. By the time I put together the staff, it was May 15th. They said, now you have to raise $350,000 by June 30th. That is the second quarter filing deadline. I said, we will do it. On June 30th, we raised $440,000. I mean, you got to believe that you want to do this thing. And we have a headquarters at 205 West Main Street, and we have a website, chivukulaforcongress.com. We have very good social media, that is where you should go on and become a friend, and you have to contribute whatever way you want to do. You can contribute, you can volunteer, you can help us out. And today, we crossed $750,000. One commercial that we put out, then at least 2 mailers went out and getting feedback. And one of the criticisms, they said, nowhere it says you're a Democrat. I said, you look like a Democrat, you talk like a Democrat, you walk like a Democrat, you are a Democrat. And so, I know Congressman Rushmore talked about some of the issues, and all of us are going to support President Barack Obama and watch the debate, and there are a lot of things that we can learn from that, and there are so many things that we can do. We have to stand behind the President. We have to support Senator Menendez, who's going through that right now. His debate with Senator Corrales is going on right now, 8-9. And so we are working hard. I think my wife, I want to just recognize how much my wife. She's removing my job security. So whenever she goes, she becomes a keynote speaker. When I go home, I hear Ian Phil saying that, hey, even Barbara Bono, she said, your wife is an amazing woman. And I said, sure, that's why I married her 35 years ago. And I was getting late, but I think, let's work together. Let's unite as Democrats. Let's put our differences aside. We have great candidates in John Pritchard and John Panzerjali and Bill Caltieri. They're running for clerk and freeholders. And lots of local candidates in many towns that were introduced by County Chair Peg Schaefer. And let's work together. We have 33 days. Somebody says 32 days. 33 days to the election, November 6th. Let's make use of the mail-in ballots.
Let's make sure that you have offices where we can do the phone banking. Let's knock on doors, do the canvassing, let's do that. And as a candidate, I believe in investing in education, protecting healthcare, protecting the senior citizens' benefits, the safety net, the social security, and making sure that we do not convert the Medicare into voucher care. So these are some of the important things. I believe in equality, gender equality, marriage equality. Let's work together as Democrats. Let's move on to a victory on November 6th. Thank you. So he would make a great congressman, yes?
Yeah.